Okay, today's project is to insert an escape board, which I left 20 feet away, between the top box, which is ready to harvest, and the box below it, which I hope the bees are rapidly filling in. I've got my smoker going. I've got some sugar syrup, one part sugar to two parts water by weight. I've got bee repellent, which I use to mask the smell of any stings I might receive so that the pheromone doesn't get the bees further excited. I have a brush, which may be useful, and I've got a hive tool to pry things apart with and possibly to squash any small hive beetles that I bump into in that process. And I've got just a few minutes of video remaining, I think. Let me get the escape board. There are a lot of models of these, and you can build your own. This one's by Saracel, a New Zealand company, and it's basically a one-way valve for bees. It's got these cones here, which are a lot easier for a bee to get through going out than back in. So when I put it in between these boxes, the bees smelling the queen or just wanting to be warm at night will by and large want to leave the top super, honey super, and go below. After that, they won't be able to get back in, really, not in any numbers. And I'll be able to remove the top super much more easily for harvest, the next step, which I anticipate will be crush and strain. So I'm going to sweeten things up around the hive entrance, which you won't be able to see, and give them a puff of smoke, because the queen may not get a full report of the party going on the hive entrance. But this syrup will at least make some workers very happy and help establish the kind of relationship I'd like to have with them right now. Now I've got this tray underneath, so I need to pull that out of the way. Got some diatomaceous earth inside, and you can see not all the bees managed to get their pollen where it ought to go. Some of it drops through the bottom screen. So let's give them a couple of puffs there. Everybody's got their own secret family formula for what they smoke with. Torn up egg cartons, burlap bags, whatever. Processed wood fuel pellets. I'm just going to leave that out for now, actually. I use cherry wood smoker pellets, and one reason is they burn slowly like the wood fuel pellets, but they're food grade. They're meant for cooking things that people are going to eat. With any luck, I'm going to eat some of the honey that comes out of this hive, and so I don't see why I shouldn't adopt food grade as a standard for anything that touches that honey. Okay, everybody on the front doorstep is pretty well sugared up. And I think this hive had their flying lessons earlier. Things have quieted down a bit. They should be a little bit less defensive. It's a fairly warm day. A lot of them are still out foraging. Might have been a little better if I'd done this earlier, but still fairly warm. And there won't be a lot of thermal shock to the hive when I open it up and get the warm air out. It's going to be a lot easier for them to recover than it would be on a cooler day. It's about 70 degrees here. So let's pop the lid. See what we can see. And No hive beetles, that's good. At this point, I think the brush will be handy. Let's give them a little syrup. It's pretty crowded in there. And I may use the smoke later. I feel that I need to use both carrot and stick. I may need to use the smoke later to chase some of the bees out of the way as I'm replacing woodware to make it less likely that they get crushed. They're sacrificing enough as it is. Let's put that out of the way. Now, ideally I'd have a cloth to cover this. I've got some hive beetle traps here that I realize besides just being mechanically tight between the frames. Okay. A few diligent workers still on there. Some of those may be house bees that aren't really capable of navigating outside the hive. So I don't want to shake them off. Unless I'm shaking them right back into the hive. There goes a hive beetle. But he's a little too quick for me. He was almost where I needed to be. That's the good news. There's a hive bee. Just a massive progress. Coming going on, which I guess you could blame on me. Syrup. Keep everybody happy. Enforce that party attitude. Spring break is just coming a little late. Hear that a few more of them have taken to the air.
It's not
bad. But, a little more smoke won't hurt. Okay, now let's see if we can loosen up this entire super. And then put the small hive beetle traps in it. I'd like to not forget that. If I'd been a little smarter, I would have a cloth to spread over the super when I set it down so that the bees in it are a little less stressed, so it's nice and dark and not drafty and chill. I mean chill in a bad way. Okay. Let's see if we can't just put this down and ideally remember which end is which. There, not for long, girls. Now, we're going to replace these small hive beetle traps. Gently. Especially here. Okay. She got an antenna pinched, I think, but only for a moment. All she needed. Okay. A little more space there. Down we go. Carefully. That's a little cockeyed. There we go. That's better. Now we can push that frame back into more of the alignment.